Belinda presents this unabridged recording of My Brother's an Egghead, written and read by Gretel Killeen. Hello, hello. Before we begin, I need to tell you seven things. One, Zeke and Eppie are brother and sister. Two, Zeke smells like a boiled egg. Three, Eppie laughs like a frog. Four, Zeke and Eppie live in a house with their mum, who does not laugh like a frog or smell like a boiled egg, but is sometimes as blind as a bat. Five, Zeke and Eppie's mum wears glasses because otherwise she sees everything like she's looking through a car windscreen on a very rainy day. Which is, of course, very dangerous because her eyes don't have windscreen wipers. Six, Zeke and Eppie love their mum, but they call her bum. This is because when Zeke was little, he had a blocked nose for about a million years, so every time he tried to say mum, it always sounded like bum. Seven. Oh, and you should also know that even though Zeke doesn't have a blocked nose anymore, he and Eppie still call their mum bum. But they do this because they think it's funny, not because their mother looks anything like a bottom. Okay, so Zeke, Eppie and Bum live in a nice house with a little garden out the front and a bigger garden out the back, where nine elephants and two gorillas could have a lovely time. But Zeke and Eppie actually want a puppy, so they don't have any elephants or any gorillas. They also don't have a lion, a rhinoceros, a pig or a dragon in their garden. But once they did find a very wrinkly witch who was wearing a towel as a cape. The witch was the old lady who lived next door. She'd crash-landed into Zeke and Eppie's garden one day when her broom ran out of petrol. And she was so embarrassed when she stopped being dizzy and saw that her pointy hat looked like a pizza box that she hopped back on her broom and ran galloped far away, riding her broom like a pony. A few weeks later, some professional basketball players moved in next door and they seemed nice, but they had to move out too because they were so tall their heads poked out of the chimney. Then for ages, or maybe just a week, no one lived in the house next door. That is, until yesterday, when a boy called Tig and a girl called Pop and a dad called Dad moved in. Of course, Zeke and Eppie spied on them to see if they were witches or basketball players or maybe even ghosts, and by the end of the day, they were completely convinced the new neighbours were aliens. Zeke and Eppie had no proof the neighbours were aliens. I mean, they weren't green, their house wasn't a spaceship, they didn't talk by making beeping sounds like a reversing car, and their father didn't seem to have a long tail like a crocodile. But then again, maybe he did have a tail. Because even though Zeke and Eppie had spied on the neighbours for hours and hours, they'd really only seen the father sitting down in a garden chair. And he was wearing a pair of very baggy tracksuit pants, which could easily have hidden a tail if you rolled the tail very tightly into a ball and then tied it up in a knot and tucked it into the back of your undies and sat on it like a cushion. Oh dear. So maybe the father did have a tail, and maybe he also had secret fangs and a brain made out of coat hangers. But the most obvious weird thing about him was the fact that he didn't seem to talk. Or move. No, he just sat like a scarecrow. And when it got dark, Tig and Pop carried him inside just after they'd folded him in half. Anyway, enough about that. Because today was a special day for three reasons. One, because it was Tig and Pop's first day at their new school, which was also the school Zeke and Eppie went to. And, two, because all the kids from every class were going on an excursion to the world's only ice cream tree, which coincidentally was growing not far away in a place called Happy Tum Forest. And, three, because Bum had invited Tig and Pop to come over and play before school. No way, said Zeke, searching the kitchen for places to hide and wondering if he could squeeze into a cutlery drawer. There is no way I'm going to play with that boy and girl. Why not? Replied Bum. Because there's something weird about them, whispered Zeke. Well, they look perfectly normal to me, said Bum. It's not the way they look that's important, said Eppie. It's the way they make us feel. And when I look at them, I feel sort of wobbly dizzy, Like that time I drank 3 chocolate milkshakes, got on the Big Dipper and vomited on a clown. Speak for yourself, interrupted Zeke, because they don't make me feel like I'm going to vomit. They make me feel like I'm in the bath, in the nude, surrounded by huge, hungry sharks. That's enough, said Bum, who was trying to tidy up before the neighbours arrived, but was so confused by the conversation that she put all the dirty breakfast plates in the fridge. They're not weird neighbours. They're just a normal boy called Tig, who is Zeke's age, and a normal girl called Pop, who's your age, Eppie.
Oh, really? Said Eppie. And how do you know all that?
Because, said Bum, I went to their house yesterday afternoon with a cake and a card to welcome them to the neighbourhood. Zeke and Eppie imagined the alien neighbours with a cake and a card. Zeke wanted to know if they ate the cake by sticking it in their ears, and Eppie wanted to know if they threw out the cake and just ate the card instead.
You two are being ridiculous, said Bum. They gobbled the cake like any normal kids would. They cut it into slices, placed it onto plates, then ate the slices with a knife and fork and dabbed the crumbs off their lips with a napkin.
You call that normal? Bellowed Zeke. I call that the behaviour of 2 kids who are pretending to be normal.
Yep, agreed Eppie. That's exactly the way really naughty alien kids would behave if they were trying to trick someone into believing they're human.
But Zeke and Eppie's mother wouldn't listen to their chatter. She'd lost her glasses, as usual, and was in a morning hurry. As usual, and was too busy getting herself ready for work and making Zeke and Eppie's lunches for school. As usual. Oh, yes. Bum was way too busy to listen to nonsense and way too busy and distracted to even notice she'd accidentally put Zeke.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.